Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Glory be to God. Thank you for joining us for another edition of Open Heaven's Devotion today, Saturday the 17th of October 2020. Please call everybody in your household as we study the Word of God together. God has kept us alive, and today we want to hear the Word of God and we want to pray. And as we continue today, shall we have a word of prayer together? Father, in the name of Jesus, we celebrate you. We thank you for your goodness, for your love, for your compassion. Thank you for exercising your discretion to keep us alive. To you and to you alone be all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor in the name of Jesus. Lord, as we go through your word today, help us to understand your word. Lord, speak to us through your word in the name of Jesus. Touch our lives. Reveal yourself to us. Fight all our battles for us and grant us victory. Thank you, mighty and everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Praise God. Once again, I welcome you. What I want you to do is to call everybody around you as we study the Word of God. The Word of God is sweet. The Word of God is beautiful. The Word of God will shape your life. It will make your life better. So as we study today, make sure that you are attentive and you follow us even as we share this word. Today, the topic we're looking at is, be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. That is the topic that we are looking at today. Be strong and courageous. A memory verse is taken from the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 31. Romans 8, 31, get your Bible and let's read together. Romans 8, 31. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? If God is on your side, who can be against you? If the Almighty God is with you, who can dare be against you? Friends, to be strong means to be able to withstand force of prayer. That's to be strong. And to be courageous is to deter. It's not to deter by danger or pain. It's to be brave. To be courageous is not to be deterred by danger or pain. To be courageous means to be brave. You are brave when you are courageous. A Bible reading today is Deuteronomy 31. And we are going to be reading from verse 5 to 8. Deuteronomy 31. From verse 5 to verse 8. Let's read together. And the Lord shall give them up before your face, that ye may do unto them according unto all the commandments which I have commanded you. Be strong and be courageous. Fear not. Be strong and be of a good courage. Fear not, nor be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he it is that doeth go with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. And Moses called unto Joshua and said unto him in the sight of all Israel, be strong and be of a good courage, for thou must go with this people unto the land which the Lord had sworn unto their fathers to give them. And thou shalt caused them to inherit it. And the Lord, He it is that doeth go before thee. He will be with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Fear not, neither be dismayed. The word of God is coming unto somebody today. Fear not. Do not be dismayed. I will go ahead of you. I will fight your battles for you. I will grant you victory in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you listening to us today and you are fearful? Are you listening today and it appears that you are so afraid to take the next step forward? Be not afraid. Be courageous. Be strong. The Lord will go ahead of you. The Lord will grant you victory. And every battles of life, God will see you through in the name of Jesus. Be strong and be courageous. When the leadership of the children of Israel was handed over to Joshua, he was really very, very afraid. He knew it will take a lot of wisdom to resolve conflict and deal with complaints among his people. Oh, he had seen, brothers and sisters, how they were faced with huge obstacles in the past. Remember the Red Sea? Lack of food and water in the wilderness? Enemies coming against them, you know, left, right, and center? Many more challenges that they have witnessed. So he knew all of this. Joshua was sure he will need special anointing, special grace, special strength to overcome such obstacle if they come again. So he knew. He was there. So he was afraid in a way. He knew that he would require the help of God, the anointing of God. Because when such situation come again, oh, Joshua knew that he needs help. Do you need help? Are you trusting God for something important? Oh, you need the strength of God today. You need to be courageous. He will help you. This word is coming to you today, and God is saying, I will help you. Be strong and be courageous. God, however, knew that with fear in the heart of Joshua, he will not be able to lead the Israelites to the promised land. So he reminded him. God knew that with that level of fear in the heart of Joshua, it would be impossible for him to carry out the task. It would be impossible for him to lead the children of Israel to the promised land. Oh, the promised land is ahead. Israelite needs a leader. Joshua has been appointed. But with this fear, it will be impossible to get to anywhere. God knew this. So God told him in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 9, Have I not commanded thee, be strong and be of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee wheresoever thou goest. This is the word of the Lord to Joshua. This is the word of the Lord reassuring Joshua, as this word is reassuring you today. Oh, have I not commanded thee? Be strong and be of a good courage. What is that fear in your life? Why are you so fearful? Is the fear of failure preventing you from taking that step? Take this step. God is with you. Hallelujah. Beloved, if you will succeed in your divine purpose and assignment, you must be strong and courageous, confident that God is with you all the time. It is important for you to remember that God is with you. Because with God on your side, you are a winner. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10. Proverbs chapter 24 verse 10 tells us, If thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. God has called us. He has called us to confront situations. He has given us the grace and he is telling us we will overcome. Only be courageous If you fail in the day of adversity, then your strength is small. Hallelujah. Now, courage, confidence, and faith in God is needed to overcome storms of life. Oh yes, friends, brothers and sisters, to overcome the storms of life, you need courage, confidence, and faith in the Almighty God. There are obstacles in life, but only those who will rise above these obstacles will sing the songs of victory. I see you singing the song of victory. I see you celebrating. I see God handing over that victory to you. Only be strong and be courageous. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you want to share testimony of great things, you need to be strong. If you want to share testimony of great things, you need to be courageous. There are, however, tools that the enemy deployed to prevent us from fulfilling our destiny. One of those tools is fear. Hallelujah. One of those tools is fear. Fear is one of the tools that the enemy uses to prevent men and women from fulfilling their destiny. Fear is the strategy of the devil to limit you. Oh yes, never allow it in your heart. Never allow fear in your heart. You know what fear is? It's false evidence appearing real. They are false. They are not there, but they appear to be real. If you take a stand, if you move in the confidence of God, fear will give way. Hallelujah. No matter how great a task is, as long as God is with you, you have succeeded already. As long as you make God your ally, you have succeeded already. As long as you are on God's side, you are on the winning side. Hallelujah. Are you on the winning side? Are you on the Lord's side? Which side are you? As you listen to us today, which side are you? God is calling you onto his side. And when you are on the side of the Almighty God, you can be sure of victory. Any day, any time. In the morning, in the noon, in the evening time, in the night time. Any time, you can be sure that God will grant you that victory. The Israelites were afraid of Goliath, remember? And will have been delivered in the hands of the Philistines. But for David's godly confidence, in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 24. 1 Samuel 17, read the story there. Now, despite the fact that David was young, the moment he stepped into the situation, everything changed. Everything changed. Hallelujah. It took a small boy, David, to step into that situation and everything changed. All God needed to deliver his people was courage, not necessarily the skills. Remember, David had no military skills. There was no military training given to David. Hallelujah. You remember when the king said he should put on all those gadgets and garments? He said, look, this thing is, they are too heavy for me. No military training at all. God needed that courage, not necessarily the skill. Your abilities are not sufficient to guarantee your success. Oh yes. God is, however, more than enough help to help you succeed. Don't trust or depend on your ability. It's not enough. It's not enough to guarantee you victory. But with God, you can achieve all that you want to achieve in life. With God helping you, be God by your side, oh, you can achieve. With God on your side, God can take you to places. Why don't you trust him today? All he needs is courage. All that David needed is courage, not experience, not connection, not skill, just courage. That's all you need. Not that connection. That human connection that you think is going to take you to where you are going. No. And I'm not saying that relationship is out of it. Relationship is good. But have the relationship with the right one. If you have a relationship with God, oh, that relationship will take you far. That relationship will take you far. Not experience. Courage is all that you need in the Lord. Have faith in God Have courage. Just courage. Remember, just courage. Good courage is taking steps in the face of fear, in the face of difficulty, in the face of danger, with confidence that God is with you. Good courage is taking that step in the face of fear. When you want to start that business and you don't know what to do, and you are fearful, have confidence in God. Fear not. When you want to take that bold step to win that soul in that difficult environment, have courage, knowing fully well that God is with you, and it shall be so. As you go about various activities today, be strong and be of a good courage. God is with you, and you will definitely overcome in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak into your life today, that God will give you courage to overcome. You will have the confidence to take that step. You need to take that step, because that is the right thing to do. Remember, just courage. You need that courage, be courageous and have that confidence in the Lord. And as you do so, the Almighty God will surprise you in the mighty name of Jesus. Just before we close, shall we have a word of prayer together? And I want you to please repeat after me. Say, Father, please banish every form of fear in my life and help me to be strong and courageous in the mighty name of Jesus. Please pray that prayer. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, banish every form of fear. Every form of fear, remove them from my life. Help me to be strong. Help me to be courageous. Help me to make that move. Help me to take that step in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Friends, if you are listening to us and you have not given your life to Jesus, take that step. Be bold and be courageous. It's the right thing to do. It's the best place to be. And so if you want to take that step today, we can pray together and you can be on the Lord's side and you're beginning to experience our Father fighting your battles for you and granting you victory. If you are ready, let's pray together. Say, Father, I come to you. Have mercy upon my soul. Save me. Deliver me. Wash my sins away with your blood. I confess you today as my Lord and Savior. Please touch me, touch my life. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, as many that are deciding for you today, please save their soul. Help them. Write their names in the book of life. Let it be well with them. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Friends, for Bible in 1 year, we are encouraged to read John chapter 6, the old chapter. John chapter 6, the old chapter. And our hymn today is hymn 26. Stand up and stand up for Jesus. Stand up and stand up for Jesus. Thank you for sharing your time with us today. Until next time we come your way, keep experiencing the power of God in the name of Jesus. God bless you.
Stand up. Stand up for Jesus, his soldiers of the cross. Lift high his royal banner, it must not suffer loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall lead, till every foe is vanquished.
let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven, let it rain. Let it sing out, let it.